Hey guys, what you guys are going to be doing as you watch this quick video here is you guys are going to be exploring a little bit more about opportunity costs and trade-offs. Every single time we make a decision, the choice that we make basically makes it impossible to make other decisions as a result, and that'll make a lot more sense when you're done watching this. As you're watching it, keep in mind the learning targets that we have on our website, and that's basically our learning goals for each one of the lessons that we're covering. The learning target for this lesson reads, I can explain how opportunity costs and opportunity benefits are involved in each and every decision that is made. So by the end of this, the hope is that you will be able to explain and basically identify whether or not you feel that you can actually explain opportunity costs and opportunity benefits and the role that they play. I'm going to come on here after the short video clip that you're going to watch, and I'm going to give you guys a little bit more direction as to what I want you to do when you come to class tomorrow. As you're actually watching the video, I do ask that you take notes on it. Be sure to get definitions of terms like opportunity cost, trade-off, scarcity, etc. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you in class tomorrow.
Hi, it's Paddy Hirsch at Marketplace. So opportunity cost, it's one of those terms that economists like to toss around. It sounds really, really complicated, but in actual fact, opportunity cost is a really simple concept. The opportunity cost of a decision that you make is quite simply the value of what you decided to give up. So for example, imagine we've got a restaurateur who wants to open a restaurant. He can either open a soup and salad place or a steak place. That's his choice. So he decides on the soup and salad place. What's the opportunity cost of that decision? Quite simply, it's the value of what he would have made every month by opening a steak place. All right? So he doesn't know necessarily what that's going to be, but he has to factor that in. What would I make from a steak place when he's making the decision about whether to open soup and salad or steak? So businesses are constantly weighing these things when they're opening up businesses or opening up lines of business or making these kinds of decisions. It's slightly different for consumers. Right? Say my friend David Weinberg here. He loves to drink juice. All right? But if he goes to Trendy Juice, it costs him $6 a pop every single time. Oh, it seems expensive. So David now has a choice. Every day he can go to Trendy Juice and buy that expensive juice, or he can go and buy a juicer and make his own juice. Say he decides to buy the juicer. Say he decides to take that option. What's the opportunity cost of that decision? Well, it's what he would have gotten if he goes for Trendy Juice every day. So what would he have gotten? Well, the first thing he would have gotten is time, right? Because it takes a lot of time to go shopping for fruits and veg when you're making your own juice. It also takes a lot of time to clean that damn machine, let me tell you. The second thing that he might have gotten is friends, because a lot of people hang out at the juice place. And David could really use some friends right now. All right, so that's the opportunity cost of that decision to go for the juicer and make that juice himself. As David likes to say, it's the road not traveled. So consumers, when they're making decisions, are always well advised to look at opportunity cost, the value of the decision that they didn't take when they make a decision, before they actually make that choice. Because if you don't, you could make the wrong decision. That could leave you very badly needing a juice.
Scarcity is the basic economic problem that arises because people have unlimited wants, but resources are limited. Because of scarcity, various economic decisions must be made to allocate resources efficiently. Some wants must be given up so that others can be achieved. The fact that choices have to be made about how to use limited resources to meet unlimited wants affects individuals, businesses, industries, governments, and even the worldwide economy. It is an important concept for the study of consumer demand and how individuals and business make consumption, production, and investment choices. At the individual level, time is an example of a scarce resource. The hours you spend working to make an income are hours that you don't spend relaxing or with your family. At the business level, money is an example of a scarce resource. The dollars spent on rent, wages, and raw materials are dollars that don't go towards profit. On the government level, land is an example of a scarce resource. With only so many square miles of usable land available, agencies from city councils to the federal government must make decisions about the best use of space. Land turned into a park is land that cannot be used for roads or houses. Ultimately, scarcity is all about compromise. In order to gain one resource, you must cut back on another.
Hey guys, now that you guys have watched a couple quick video clips on opportunity cost and trade-offs, What I want you to do below the notes that you've taken in your notebook is I want you to just note 3 to 5 different decisions that you've made in the last 3 months. They don't have to be humongous life-changing things, but 3 to 5 decisions that you've made. And then next to those decisions, I want you to list 3 to 5 opportunity costs associated with the decision that you made. Then when we come to class tomorrow at the start of the hour, we'll take some time and share the decisions that we've made and the opportunity costs, or what we gave up when we made those decisions, with the people in class. And then we're going to do an activity that goes with this. So thank you very much. I will again see you tomorrow.